In this video, we're computing a definite integral of sine 2x times e to the sine squared x. And we're given instructions on how to approach the problem here. We're asked to apply the trig identity sine 2x is 2 sine x cosine x. So that's going to transform this first part of the integral. And then we're asked to use an explicit u substitution to transform the integral, and we're told to transform the limits of integration as we do this. So first I apply the trig identity, and I notice that in the front of this integral, 2 sine x cosine x, that's the derivative of the exponent on that exponential function. When I use the chain rule on the square of the sine function, I bring down the 2 out in front of it, and I get 2 sine x, and then I have to tack on the derivative of sine x. So that's exactly what we're looking at out in front of this integral. This makes me very hopeful that the u substitution is going to work, so we just let u equal that exponent sine squared x. And again, when we take the derivative of that, we have to differentiate with respect to the sine function, so I get 2 sine x. And then the chain rule says you have to differentiate the sine function with respect to x, so that's cosine x, and there's a dx on that. Then we want to transform the limits of integration as well. So when x is 0, that's the lower limit, u is going to be the square of the sine of 0, but the sine of 0 is just 0. So u begins at 0. And then I look at the upper limit, that's a pi over 2. And when I plug in x equals pi over 2, the sine of that is 1, and when I square that, it's still 1. So my upper limit is u equals 1. Now our integral has been transformed entirely in terms of u, and I'm integrating as u goes from 0 to 1. Then e to the sine squared x is just e to the u. And then 2 sine x cosine x times dx, that's just du. And the antiderivative of e to the u is just itself. And I get e to the u evaluated from 0 to 1. I plug in the upper limit and I get e. Plug in the lower limit and I get e to the 0, which is 1. So the value of this integral is e minus 1. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.